Здравствуйте, меня зовут Александра, и сегодня мы поменяемся местами с Азатом и Анной, и сегодня я бы хотела у них провести небольшое интервью. В университете нам поступило задание провести небольшое исследование по предмету «Покупательское поведение, consumer behavior». И задача состоит в том, чтобы узнать отношение покупателей к вопросу покупки как продуктов, так и вещей. Вот, надеюсь, само исследование будет происходить на английском языке, так как группа у нас международная, и профессор у нас индус будет проверять, чтобы ему было возможно посмотреть результаты. После этого исследования мы будем делать анализ, с которым я поделюсь с вами позже. So, Azat, we just discussed questions with your wife. Now it's time to ask you a question about food and clothes to you. Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
So, the first chapter will be devoted to food. What is your favorite food?
My favorite food is natural food. I like steamed rice, steamed vegetables. I like meat, grilled meat. I like soups. So this kind of food I like.
Okay. Primarily, do you eat at home or outside?
Normally we eat at home almost every day, but sometimes when we go out with friends or we just want to see some places, sometimes we can dine out or just to have some lunch outside also.
Nice. So how often do you eat outside?
I guess it is like once a week maybe, sometimes more often, sometimes less often, but normally like once a week, yeah.
So it can be dinner or lunch?
Normally it is dinner, but at lunchtime sometimes we can go just to have some coffee with the partners or with the colleagues or with just friends in at lunchtime.
So if you eat out, what type of meal is it?
So, as I told you before, sometimes it can be just a cup of coffee. For example, I like a cappuccino, or for example, I can take fresh juice, it is also nice, and I also like to take Moroccan tea. It's very nice in Lebanese and Arabic restaurants. And also we sometimes take fish, like homur fish. I like whole fish when it's whole, not
pieces. Yeah.
And also I like lamb chops very much. I'm not a fan of French fries, but sometimes it's also
like a dish.
It's like side dish. Sometimes it's okay.
So what is your favorite cuisine, by the way?
My favorite cuisine is Russian.
Okay.
Definitely, because it is very rich and it has many ingredients, many vegetables and also meat, and also Russian cuisine has some some items made of pastry, for example, some cookies, some cakes, different kinds of food.
Do you go out to have Russian cuisine?
Actually, no. Here in Dubai, I don't know some very nice Russian restaurant. So normally, the best Russian food I had in Dubai it is food. Yeah, that's my wife is cooking normally.
Okay, that's nice. Do you cook?
Here in Dubai, I guess I cooked maybe few times, like four or five, but. If to be frankly, I love to cook. I love cooking. Normally, I like to cook fish, but here in Dubai, it is very fish market is very far from us. So, and in our shop where we take food, there is no good quality fresh fish, so we don't take fish here in the shop. So now I don't cook in Dubai normally.
Okay. Who cook in your family and how often?
My wife, she is cooking in our family, and she's cooking like 3 or 4 times a week, this year.
Okay. What are the products of your first necessity?
It is bread, milk, water, Normally we take minced meat. It's very mm-hmm. easy to cook something from minced meat. So for my wife, mm-hmm. when she's also working, so mm-hmm. she has not too much time for cooking. So when we have mm-hmm. minced meat at home, she can make food very mm-hmm. easily and fast.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And also we like to eat some Arabic sweets and tea, for example, coffee, like this mm-hmm. kind of food also.
That's nice. How often do you shop?
You mean for food?
Yeah, for food. Yeah. The first chapter is for food.
We go for food anytime we need it. Mm-hmm. We need it because this shop is in the same building, in our building, mm-hmm. on the ground floor. So if I will need some food after 1 hour, I just can go down my building and take what we need. So we go.
It can be particular every day.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Primary, what type of shops, for example, hypermarkets, supermarkets, and as you told, it's a shop in the mm-hmm. building, you prefer?
We have mini market in mm-hmm. our building. It is mm-hmm. a Carrefour market.
So do you prefer to buy there or go to hypermarket?
I prefer to buy here because mm-hmm. we don't have a car and to take mm-hmm. big bags and carry these big bags from, for example, from hypermarket mm-hmm. to our home. It is very far and mm-hmm. convenient. It is better for me to go down my building and take like one small bag here for 1 day, for two mm-hmm. days, and that's all. And it's also very useful for us mm-hmm. because we can take every day we can take fresh yeah.
Mm-hmm. What is the most important in choice of choosing shopping place?
As for me, mm-hmm. it is most important is location.
Location.
Even if it is more expensive, for mm-hmm. example, I would better prefer the shop mm-hmm. the shop in my building than going to far away mm-hmm. Just to save 1 or 2 dirhams. It is, mm-hmm. it doesn't worth this. Mm-hmm. So.
What about time? Saving time, for example, if you go shopping downstairs.
Yeah, definitely. It mm-hmm. will save my time mm-hmm. and it will save also, how to say it, it was, you know, it is very hot in Dubai mm-hmm. and when you go very far, you become sweat. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. So it will also save my clothes.
Yes, I agree with you. In what part of the day do you usually go shopping for food?
For food, normally afternoon. Or by the evening, mm-hmm. like this, yeah.
Okay. How much time do you usually spend on buying food?
20 to 30 minutes
20
maximum.
20 to 30 minutes
yeah.
maximum.
Because we take only that we mm-hmm. only these products that we need. We don't take mm-hmm. Too much.
Okay, for the first
just,
days. Yeah,
we mm-hmm. just take what we need like for today or for mm-hmm. tomorrow, like one piece of bread, one mm-hmm. one bottle of water, for example, and one chicken, mm-hmm. so like this.
Okay, that's nice.
It doesn't take too much time.
Mm-hmm. What kind of food do you usually buy? For example, just a list of food you can buy. For example.
Normally we buy laban, mm-hmm. nuts, chicken, vegetables, mm-hmm. Tea, coffee, milk, water. What else? This kind of food. Mm-hmm. Normal food that we eat every day. So. We don't eat some exotic food, like I don't know, like some Chinese or mm-hmm. I don't know, like Indian mm-hmm. food. We don't eat very spicy food, so we take food that we got used to eat in Russia. Yeah, mm-hmm. and sometimes we take some Russian items also, some, for example, buckwheat mm-hmm. or this small cucumbers, mm-hmm. we call them in Russia cornichons. Mm-hmm. And also I like to eat olives, mm-hmm. So this kind of food.
Okay, nice. How do you usually shop, alone or with your family? Again, according to the food.
It depends. If my wife is busy, I can mm-hmm. go alone just to buy a few items. Mm-hmm. But sometimes we go together, for example, when we have to take more mm-hmm. items. For example, when we plan to make some party at home, mm-hmm. for example, when we plan to invite friends. Mm-hmm. So then we go together and shop together.
Okay. What does influence on your product choice?
On my product choice, I guess quality mm-hmm. is the first, and second is this product should be familiar to me, mm-hmm. you know, because here in Dubai too many nationalities living, mm-hmm. and when you go to the shop and see some food which looks very unusual or looks very exotic, mm-hmm. I will think twice
before buying.
Yeah, before buying. You know, one time we took avocado, mm-hmm. yeah, and I decided that we will not take it anymore.
You don't like it?
We just wanted to try it, mm-hmm. so we just tried not mm-hmm. to put it in the salad, but
okay, just to
eat as a fruit, mm-hmm. yeah, just to, like, you know, as a mango, for mm-hmm. example, mm-hmm. to eat. But I didn't like this, so we decided, okay, no more avocado, we'll better take mango, like bananas or mm-hmm. apple, the food that we got used to eat in Russia.
Okay.
Yeah.
How long do you use products?
What do you mean?
It's on average, for example, the whole products. How often do you exchange your fragile?
Exchange what?
Exchange fragile, the products in fragile. For example, one week. Mm. Week.
As I told you, we take mm-hmm. almost every day we take fresh, so our fridge is
mm-hmm. it's not full, particularly.
Yeah, it is not mm-hmm. full. It is like a few items are in the mm-hmm. fridge, so when they finish, we go downstairs mm-hmm. and buy fresh.
Do you support local producers, or do you believe in world-known brand quality?
It depends on product. Mm-hmm. You know, for example, when it comes to eggs, mm-hmm. I must be sure 100% that they're mm-hmm. fresh. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we take local eggs. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to, for example, nuts, mm-hmm. I'm not sure that there are some local nuts. Mm-hmm. They are all imported.
Yeah.
So we have no choice. We have mm-hmm. to take imported nuts. When it comes, for example, for dates, yeah, sometimes mm-hmm. we take dates. Sometimes we take Emirati dates from mm-hmm. our shop, mm-hmm. but frankly speaking, I like more Iranian dates, but mm-hmm. We can find them in Deira, so mm-hmm. when we go to Deira sometimes, we take Iranian mm-hmm. from there, Iranian dates. Mm-hmm. When it comes to milk or bread, so mm-hmm. when it is very important for the product to be fresh, mm-hmm. so we have to take local food, mm-hmm. but when it comes when freshness of the product is not essential, mm-hmm. we can take any of them on our taste.
Okay. Before going to buy food, do you write a list of the product and follow it strictly?
before we were making like some kind of list of mm-hmm. products. But then we decided that it takes too much time mm-hmm. for making this list. It is better to go and see. Maybe you will like some
to take everything by chance.
Yeah. Because, you know, for example, if we don't have bananas at home today, mm-hmm. but I go to the shop, I don't want to buy bananas. Mm. We don't have them at home, and I don't want to take them because I had bananas mm-hmm. like 2-3 days ago. Ate like 10 of bananas, many, mm-hmm. yeah. So I'm full of them. I don't want to see them anymore in my house for the next few days. But sometimes, for example, if I want to take, for example, lemon, mm-hmm. I can just
take it.
Yeah. So
okay. And the next question is, while shopping, do you prefer to buy product that you've already known? Or do you prefer to try something new?
I prefer to take products that I now already mm-hmm. know. Mm-hmm. But sometimes, for example, when salesperson in the mm-hmm. shop, if salesperson can advise something to mm-hmm. me, I take and try. Yeah.
Okay. What kind of special offers in the store can attract your attention? For example, as you mentioned, it can be sampling. Yeah, when you try something new, when the salesperson can explain you and say that you can try this. What else, for example? Is it maybe brightness of advertisement or discounts?
I guess probably location of the product is important, because you know some products are very very far on far dark shelves and it is very scary to go inside. So, but when this product is visible, when it is near, for example, when I go to take milk and some product is on my way, I can just have a look on it and take a decision. Do I want to take it or do I want to try or do I not want to try?
And the last question in the first chapter. Are you a participant of a program of loyalty of any store?
Yes.
Which one?
We have a Carrefour. My club. Yeah, because it is in our building on the ground floor, so it is very convenient every time we.
Do you find it beneficial?
It is not too much beneficial, you know. You have to spend 5,000 dirhams to get 50 dirhams coupon. Yeah, it is not too much beneficial, but it is some kind of a game, and I find it a little bit funny.
Funny, but not beneficial too
much. Not too much beneficial, but you know, it's like some kind of habit. You take your money out of a wallet and you also give your card and then you take the card. It is like some kind of I got used to this and like it's some kind of how to say it, privilege.
Habit.
Yeah, some kind of habit, yeah. Just to give this card and take it back. But when finally you get this coupon for 50 dirhams, sometimes you feel better.
Better.
Yeah.
So let's discuss clothes now. What is your usual outfit?
What
outfit?
Do you mean?
So what do you usually wear?
Normally I wear shirts and trousers. So it is my
Skirts or t-shirts?
I can wear shorts or t-shirts. For example, when we go for a beach or for example when we have days off. But normally in business days, in working days, I wear often 99.9% I wear trousers and like some kind of classic trousers, not jeans. I don't like to wear jeans. I don't know why. And I wear a shirt. That's all.
How can you define your style?
I guess it's some kind of smart casual. Casual. I'm not very very keen in all the styles. I just I don't know how to call it.
So why do you choose this style?
It's just very comfortable for me, these clothes, and it also, how to say it, it is also some kind of office style, so I can go to any office and and will not offend any person, you know, by my appearance. So that's how it goes.
Yeah. What relations exist between your style and your personality?
I guess my style is a full representation of my personality. I don't like to wear some exotic, you know, these clothes or very colorful clothes or some kind of, you know, some extreme style clothes. I don't like this kind of clothes, and also my personality is the same. Maybe I'm some kind of conservative person, and my style is like this kind of, yeah.
How often do you buy clothes and from where?
Normally we do shopping for clothes like once a month, and we go with my wife to Mall of the Emirates. It is very convenient for us because we live in JLT, so it is very near to us, and also we can find in the Mall of Emirates, we can find all brands, all popular brands, and also the quality is very, very good.
While shopping, do you prefer to go to directly to the one store, or you prefer to go around and see everything what happened?
Oh, I don't like. Actually, I don't like the process of shopping. Yeah, mm-hmm. Because it takes too much time walking, and trying on. Oh, do you have the same but another size? Do you have the same size but another color? And some, you know, and there is too much people in the normally in the mall. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I have some shops, few shops in mm-hmm. In the Mall of Emirates, which
and you go directly.
Yeah, which I normally go mm-hmm. every time. So normally I go directly to the shops, but sometimes, for example, I can just go and check some other shop just mm-hmm. for just to check what's new is going on mm-hmm. there.
Okay, approximately, what is the minimum time you spend on shopping?
Like maybe 3 or 4 hours.
Hours. Mm-hmm. With whom do you usually go shopping?
I go with my wife normally. Mm-hmm. We go together. Why? Mm-hmm. Because she can help me and mm-hmm. To look at me from the side and tell me what suits to me, what doesn't suit to me. You know, when you go to the shop alone, a salesperson can say, "Oh, you look perfect. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's very nice." But it is not always mm-hmm. true. Or, you know, even here in Dubai, in some shops, they can even give you a shirt mm-hmm. and they don't open it for it. They just give it to you closed in the packaging and tell you, "Yeah, that's okay. You can take it and no need mm-hmm. to try. Mm-hmm. You just can it." But I didn't use to do shopping like this. Mm-hmm. For me, before buying some clothes, I need to try. It is mm-hmm. 100%. I never buy without trying. So when I try something, so a salesperson can say, "Oh, that's good, you look perfect." Mm-hmm. But when I ask my wife, "Please tell me," she said, "Oh, no, let's go out of here." Like this. I trust her. So, choice. Yeah, mm-hmm. her choice, so she's final decision maker.
Nice. Before buying decision on clothes, what are the important factors that come in your mind? So, for example, it's wife advice.
Yeah.
What else? Maybe price or what? So, what is important before buying? What are you thinking about before buying?
I think about, first of all, I see the quality of mm-hmm. Clothes, yeah? Mm-hmm. It should be like, it should be good quality, it should not be, how to say it, made of very cheap mm-hmm. fabrics, you know? It should be like not too much, do you know this? I like a more natural mm-hmm. fabric, like cotton or mm-hmm. like mixed fabrics, okay. like 80% cotton mm-hmm. or 20% whatever, mm-hmm. for example.
Synthetics,
yes, yeah. Synthetics maybe. So this is also important mm-hmm. for me, and also it is important for me the design of the mm-hmm. of clothes. So I don't like very loose clothes. I mm-hmm. don't like. I like some kind of slim fit clothes mm-hmm. for me, because I'm not a fat man. I'm thin, so mm-hmm. for me this suits better.
Okay. What inspires you for purchase? So what make you high before purchase?
Make me
high, for example. Ну что вдохновляет тебя на покупку?
А. You know, it is very. Actually, I don't like shopping, mm-hmm. as I told before, but you know, but when I come back home from the mall, from the after shopping, it makes me happy that I have new clothes, mm-hmm. that I can try something, that I can wear something new, that you know, new clothes, they are more they are more comfortable to mm-hmm. body. So probably this inspires me for shopping, just to get some new clothes and mm-hmm. And to get more
new emotions.
Yeah, new emotions. Yeah, mm-hmm. Right.
Which brand do you prefer the most?
Actually, I not very how to say it, not very crazy about brands. For me, it's very important to just for clothes to suit me. But I have few shops, for example, Azaro shop in Mall of Emirates, and also, and that's all. I mean, if when it comes to brands, and all other clothes I just can take from
to consider it.
I consider different brands normally.
With globalization and culture, sharing same human behavior for one society. So how does your culture affect in your clothing purchases?
Here in Dubai?
Yes, here in Dubai.
Here in Dubai, actually, it is very convenient that you don't have to buy winter clothes, you know. No need to take these coats, overcoats, or some, you know, these warm shoes. So, also these hats, yeah. So, in Russia, I got used to wear hats and all these coats, but here, I normally wear just... how to say it, summer clothes, but I never tried to wear some traditional clothes, I never tried to wear, and I never tried to wear some kind of maybe Indian clothes or what else, that's it.
Some people are shopaholic and mostly they buy clothes but don't wear them. What do you think? Are you a man of them?
No, I'm not shopaholic. When I take some clothes, when I buy, I definitely buy them with intention to wear. Yeah. There is no one item in my wardrobe that I don't wear. I always wear. Maybe some clothes I like to wear more often. Some of them I like to wear
really.
Yeah, but in general, yeah, I wear all of them.
Well, let's continue. Do you buy online?
No, when it comes to clothes, I never buy online because, you know, it is very hard to understand. Will it suit you or not? You can see beautiful pictures you can see in the internet, like some models wearing wearing clothes and they look very great, but as I told you before buying, I'm always try clothes on myself. But when it comes to some, for example, some like devices, yeah, I can do it online. I have done it a few times, like to buy some devices like flash drives or some, for example, some kind of microphone or keyboard or this kind of stuff I can buy online.
How often do you buy online? So, this type of products?
Maybe 2 or 3 times a year. Not very often. And also books, yeah. I had a few times I bought books online when I was in Russia. Not in Dubai, I bought only 2 times I bought online. So that's it.
Do you buy using magazines?
No. I know that there is some kind of special magazines for like catalogs for shopping, but I think that it is old style shopping because, you know, world is changing very fast and all these models that are listed in the catalog, probably they also, they can be out of, how to say it? Out of style, or you know,
old fashioned.
Yeah, you know, it takes too much time to make these photos for catalog, to issue catalog, to send it, this catalog. It will take too much time, so it is better to go to the shop and see what's coming new in the shop.
How important would you rate the different advertising in influencing your choice of clothes purchased?
Different
advertising? Yeah, advertising. How advertising influence on your choice?
For clothes?
Yeah, for clothes.
You mean TV or radio,
different
internet?
Different types of advertising, for example, that influence on your choice. What can attract your attention? Or, for example, while you see advertisement and you like it, will you buy the same clothes?
I have never done this. All my clothes I have bought before, I didn't see them on any posters, on in any commercials, in any advertisements. I guess no.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I guess so. No. Because you know, my problem is that of my body. Not every shop has a size of how to say it, of clothes that mm-hmm. suits me. So maybe problem is in that. So I go to some. There are only few shops where I can find small size for myself.
Okay. Today is a social media revolution for every business. What do you think specially in clothes purchase in the question of social media?
Regarding the social media itself, sorry, as a phenomenon, as a community, mm-hmm. I think it is a great idea for promoting different kinds of activities, for mm-hmm. promoting different kinds of events. But when it comes to clothes, anyway, for me, social media, they do not help me to buy clothes, to buy some new shirt or trousers, you know. As when it comes to clothes, I think it is, as for me, mm-hmm. I guess it is useless.
Okay.
But for different activities, for different, for example, services, mm-hmm. I guess it is, yeah, it is great. Or maybe for, you know, some how to say this, like artists, mm-hmm. so for composers, for творческие личности, mm-hmm. how to say it.
Yeah, artists.
Yeah, for artists, for paint, who yeah. paint, mm-hmm. who write music. And for like for personal promotion, mm-hmm. it is a great instrument for them.
Yeah. Old clothes fortune. What do you do with your old clothes?
With my old clothes, I just tell my wife what would we do with our old clothes. I ask her and. I normally they stay in our wardrobe,
mm-hmm.
and then someday maybe we decide what to do with them. Maybe throw away. Normally, I guess like this. Yeah, but here when we were in Russia, we were like how to say it? Revising our clothes, like once a half year, like mm-hmm. this, two times a year, we were revising and throwing away old ones. But here in Dubai, we are living only for 9 months, so mm-hmm. we didn't do it yet, actually.
Okay. The last question: one man's junk is another man's treasure. Do you agree or disagree?
Yeah, I agree with this statement. Because all people are different, and every person has its own personality, and he or she has its own habits, own sense of style, or how to say it, own mentality. So what is good for me, maybe not very good for you. It is normal and it is great because of this we have this variety of our world, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, that's nice. Thank you very much, Azat.
Thank you so much. It was my pleasure to share my experience with you.
For me, I will share the results of our research. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, bye-bye.